at once.
Where are we going, Captain?
Several places. You all have your guns? Saddle up at once. John, Frederick, you heard what I said.
Wisdom. He preserveth not the life of the wicked.
If they obey him not, they shall perish by the sword.
Thou hast fulfilled the judgment of the wicked.
And the justice of God has taken hold of thee.
Brown, please.
Strike the blow of the Lord.
Five people perished at large.
Five of the guilty will perish today.
Those men. How do you know they were guilty of anything?
They were seen at Lawrence. Sherman. Their names are next on the list.
Get to your horses.
Quick.
Let's train up.
Yes, right away.
What did you hope to achieve by coming alone to Palmyra?
You all have your guns?
The Army has orders from Washington to bring you to trial. I hope that if I came face to face with you first, a lot of unnecessary bloodshed might be avoided for your men and mine.
Were you innocent enough to think that I would surrender myself to you without a fight?
I hope that you might consider yourself innocent enough to do that. Half of the people in America believe in your theory. A lot of them even condone your methods. That'll guarantee you a public trial.
I'm not on trial, but the nation itself. Are you too stupid and blinded by a uniform to see what I see? A dark and evil curse laying all over this land. A carnal sin against God.
Who can only be wiped out in blood.
Why in blood? The people of Virginia have considered the resolution to abolish slavery for a long time. They sense that it's a moral wrong.
Frederick.
And the rest of the South will follow Virginia's example. All they ask is time.
Time? For 30 years I've waited for the South to cleanse its soul of this crime. Since childhood I have been possessed of the fire of correcting this wrong.
He preserveth not the life of
the wicked. I tried peaceful agitation.
If they obey him not.
As God is my witness, I tried.
Thou hast fulfilled the judgment of the wicked.
Peaceful means failed long ago. Now I shall force a decision by bringing both sides into armed conflict. Letters, words, talk. The time has ended for that. Strength and action are wanted now.
Please.
Not a voice crying in the wilderness, but a David armed with the power and the glory.
The blow of the Lord.
David had a son.
Son. Yes, that's it. He deserted his father and went over to the enemy. What are you trying to tell me,
son? Absalom died because he feared his father.
Jason's dead.
Abraham.
Son of God. It shall not be in vain. We got him, Captain.
Whether you kill me or not, the army will crush you all in the end.
My advice to you is to find peace with your maker.
Five of the guilty will perish today.
Those men, Father. How do you know they were guilty of anything?
They were seen at...
Are you sure? I was up at Potawatomi the day you killed five men in full blood.
Hear me, O Israel! As thy children were delivered from bondage, so too will my children know freedom. My children, from this time forward, and for all time, so are you free.
Free?
To the New Jerusalem!
For you at the inn. Bring him with you. Make him come.
All right. Drive to the inn.
The South knuckles under. This tyranny of the North, gentlemen. Then the South is lost.
He's right.
Lost by cowards and traitors. If John Brown does not hang tomorrow morning, if you gentlemen of the Virginia militia let them stop you, then Harper's Ferry are words of infamy.
Right. Yeah.
Its name will ring on every abolitionist tongue like a death knell for the South.
Right.
Let that gallows tell the North that Southern blood will drench each inch of soil in preference to dishonor.
Right.
Good. Great events bring strangers, even brothers together. Two whiskeys. Oh, is what I hear.
Harper's Ferry, miss. Now, please hurry. They already shot one man. Come on.
Step lively now. We're gonna make you slavers dance to a different tune.
We're here to feed the slaves in Virginia.
I demand to know why we're being held like this.
One more move and you won't be traveling on, slaver.
Put down your gun, Oliver. We have no quarrel with these people.
I take it that you are the leader here, sir.
I am, sir. And I advise you to use a more respectful tone when speaking to me and my men. You have the honor of addressing Captain Smith, Commander-in-Chief of the Provisional Government of the United States. And these are members of my staff.
You talk as though we're at war, sir.
We most certainly are at war. My men and I came all the way from Kansas to make sure justice prevails and to ensure the freedom of Negroes in this state.
What will you do to us?
I mean you no harm. But the militia must be convinced of our purpose.
To free the slaves of this state.
Then they call for a truce, and we'll negotiate for your release. But I warn you, one move is made against me and my men, we shoot to kill.
Captain! I heard the militia's on its way. Some of them town folks got guns, too.
Oliver, get these people back on the train. We're going to move it out.
What about hostages?
We'll take them out of the town.
Move!
We don't have much time.
All right! Get those people back on the train!
All right, get them locked out of there.
We ain't got much time now.